I don't have a thinking cap, but I do have a thinking tie. Today we're going to do some thinking about epidemiology. What is that? Well, epidemiologists are the scientists who investigate the mysteries of disease, and they ask questions: who, what, where, when, and try to piece it all together. Historically, the first epidemiologist probably was Hippocrates, the most famous of the ancient Greek physicians. How so? Because he dismissed the idea that diseases were caused by gods by having offended them. He suggested that diseases had physical causes. He noticed, for example, that people who lived in swampy areas were more likely to develop high fevers. He didn't understand why. It took 2,000 years until Walter Reed figured out that it was the bite of the mosquito that caused yellow fever and malaria. But at least Hippocrates introduced the idea of making observations about disease. Surprisingly, though, no one picked up the mantle of Hippocrates until, some 1,800 years had passed. And then we come to a pivotal moment in epidemiology. And that brings us to lemons and limes. And a Scottish physician by the name of James Lind, who was intrigued by scurvy. And that was a disease that affected sailors who had been at sea for a long time. He didn't know why, but he thought maybe it had something to do with the diet. So he began to investigate, carrying out what is probably the first real clinical trial. He gave some sailors extracts of various kinds of fungi. He gave others diluted sulfuric acid. And to some, he gave citrus fruits. And it turned out that the sailors who got citrus fruits never came down with scurvy. Tradition has it that the reason that the English today are called limeys is because limes were used. Although I can't find any historical record of that. It was mostly lemons and sometimes oranges. And you would think that such a breakthrough would get immediate attention. No, it took several decades until the English made sailors drink citrus juice on voyages. Not much later, another breakthrough event. And that had to do with water. Well, today, of course, we understand that water can carry disease. That wasn't known back then, until John Snow, a fascinating physician who also happened to be a physician on Queen Victoria, was investigating cholera, a terrible disease. And he took a map of the city of London, and he plotted the houses where people suffered from cholera. And he discovered that these houses centered around a pump in Broad Street. It was a public water pump. And he surmised that it was water drawn from the pump that caused the disease. And he asked the mayor to remove the handle of the pump to stop the disease. And indeed, that is just what happened. Although by the time the pump was removed, the disease had begun to wane. But this was a breakthrough moment in epidemiology because Snow noticed what was happening, how it was happening, and why it was happening. Although this was before Pasteur had introduced the germ theory of disease, so he couldn't really explain the microbiology of it. But he did tie dirty water to disease. And to this day, John Snow is remembered. Every year in London, the John Snow Society organizes a lecture. It's called the Pump Handle Lecture. And they invite noted speakers to talk about some aspect of epidemiology. And I just hope that sometime in the future, one of those lectures, one of the pump handle lectures, will deal with COVID and will have the answer to how we have solved that problem.
Oh.